or your children needs to be fed, please do so outside. Thank you for your cooperation. Before we start, we have a few announcements. Today, the Santo Niño Fiesta will be held at this church, St. Ignatius Church. The novena and procession begin at 2:30 at the entrance to Kibi Hall. Then the English Mass and Blessing of Santo Niño statues takes place from 3 p.m. After the Mass, a fellowship program follows at 4 p.m. in Joseph Hall. Today we celebrate the second Sunday in Ordinary Time. The celebrant this afternoon is Father Shia, assisting at the altars. Altar are Senichi Haruka, Shania Erika, Henry, Yuji, and Kenji. The Eucharistic ministers are Nakayama-san, Takei-san, Kambe-san, Onishi-san. The first reader is Rita, the second reader is Mitsuka. I will be your lector, my name is Susan. Please stand and please join the choir in singing the entrance hymn, page 728 at the green books in front of you. 728, verses 1, 2, and 3, verses 1, 2, and 3.
Thank you. while we can serve you and our neighbor, make us listen to your voice. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you speak to us when people appeal to our sense of justice, mercy, or compassion. Make us listen to your voice, Lord. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Forgive us, Lord, for we have turned a deaf ear to you when you spoke to us. Make us listen to you and lead us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. Let us pray that we may become aware of Jesus' call. God our Father, we believe in your Son, Jesus Christ. Open our ears to listen to his word. Open our hearts that we may experience his message as a call addressed personally to each one of us. And may we say, here I am, Lord, I come to do your will. We ask this in the name of Jesus the Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Now we listen to the word of God.
Samuel was led in the sanctuary of the Lord, where the ark of God was. When the Lord called, Samuel, Samuel, he answered, here I am. Then he ran to Eli and said, here I am, since you called me. Eli said, I did not call. Go back and lie down. So he went and lay down. Once again the Lord called, Samuel, Samuel. Samuel got up and went to Eli and said, here I am, since you called me. He replied, I did not call you, my son. Go back and lie down. Samuel has yet no knowledge of the Lord, and the word of the Lord has not yet been revealed to him. Once again the Lord called, the third time. He got up and went to Eli and said, here I am, since he called me. Eli then understood that it was the Lord who was calling the boy, and he said to Samuel, go and lie down. And if somebody calls, say, speak, Lord, your servant is listening. So Samuel went and lay down in his place. The Lord then came and stood by, calling as he had done before, Samuel, Samuel. Samuel answered, speak, Lord, your servant is listening. Samuel grew up, and the Lord worked with him. And let no word of his fall to the ground. This is the word of the Lord. For our response of your son, here am I, Lord. I come to do your will. Response?
Here
I waited. I waited for the Lord, and he stood down to me. He heard my cry. He put a new song into my mouth. Praise of our God. Response?
Hear my
Lord. I come to the Lord. You do not ask for sacrifice and offerings, but an open ear. You do not ask for holocaust and victim. Instead, hear my response.
Hear my Lord.
In the scroll of the book, it stands written that I should do your will. My God, I delight in your law in the depths of my heart. Response.
Amen.
The body is not meant for fornication. It is for the Lord, and the Lord for the body. God, who raised the Lord from the dead, will by his power raise us up too. You know surely that your bodies are members making up the body of Christ. Anyone who is joined to the Lord is one spirit with him. Keep away from fornication. All the other sins are committed outside the body, but to fornicate is to sin against your own body. Your body, you know, is the temple of the Holy Spirit, who is in you since you received him from God. You are not your own property. You have been bought and paid for. That is why you should use your body for the glory of God. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Please stand for the gospel acclamation. All together, alleluia, alleluia. We have on the side Jesus Christ, who brings us truth and grace. Alleluia.
And the Lord be with you. Jesus happened to pass by, and John looked at him and said, "Look, there is the Lamb of God." Hearing this, the two disciples followed Jesus. And Jesus turned around, saw them following, and asked, "What do you seek?" They answered, "Rabbi," which means teacher, "where do you live?" "Come and see," he replied. Went and they saw where he lived, and they stayed with him the rest of that day. It was about the 10th hour. Now one of these two who became followers of Jesus after hearing what John had said was Andrew, brother of Simon Peter. Early the next morning, Andrew met his brother and said to him, "We have found the Messiah," which means the anointed one, the Christ. And he took Simon to Jesus. Jesus looked at Simon and said, "You are Simon, son of John. You are to be called Cephas," meaning the rock. And this is the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated for the moment.
What do you see? What do you see? In our life, introductions are very important. Often the friends will introduce another friend. I'm sure at school, many boys, many girls who might take a liking to another boy or girl will ask a friend, "Introduce me. I'd like to meet her or him." Of course, in the world of business, introductions are very important. Certainly here in Japan, more formal than they are where I come from in the United States, with the presentation of your business card in the nation. Often, in business, there are letters of introduction. And with our new technologies, we now have email introductions. In fact, one of the Jesuits in being on an advisory board for the Cristo Rey School. So introductions are always part of our life. We're always being introduced. Now today in the Gospel we see two disciples of John and how they convert to Jesus. John points out to his disciples, there is the Lamb of God. And we hear that these two, of John's anyway, break away. They leave John, abandon following him, and they follow this stranger. And Jesus sort of turns and notices two people are either following him or stalking him, one or the other. And he says, "What do you seek?" They say, "Well, where do you live?" Jesus says, "Come and see." And we hear that they go and spend the day with him. Now, the details of the conversion are not that important. Obviously, much more went on than these few words. But whatever went on during that day, these people, Andrew and the other disciple, were totally changed, totally transformed by the fact that they met this newcomer who John says is the Lamb of God. And then we see the next day, Andrew runs to his brother Peter to announce, "We have found the Messiah." Notice the conversion here. Not just another prophet or another teacher or even one like John. No, Andrew is telling his brother, it's the Messiah. This is the one our people have been waiting for hundreds of years, generations, promised by prophets long ago. Andrew, like any one of us, wants to share something so important, so good, with those we love. And for Andrew, his brother was the closest he had. And then we see that Peter, on the testimony of his brother, he goes, responds to this invitation, and he meets Jesus. And with that, we hear that Peter gets a new name. Again, we don't know all that was said and done, but whatever happened in getting a new name means that Peter is a new person. He now is a follower. So this is a short scene, but packed with a lot of information. If we look at this gospel closely, we see that in the Gospel of John, the first words spoken by Jesus coming out of his mouth in this gospel is that question, "What do you see?" Directed to Andrew and the other disciple. Yes, but also, I think the writer of the gospel is directed to us. Jesus, like in a theater, is speaking to the people on stage, "What do you see?" But also to the audience who hear this gospel, "What do you see?" It's an invitation. It's a choice with no compulsion. Free to follow or not. We see that Andrew and another disciple, on the word of John, decide to accept that invitation. Others obviously did not. But everyone who gets to Jesus is going to get there by someone else. Peter couldn't do it alone. He needed to be led by his brother. Now, if we look at ourselves, we didn't get here alone. We were led to Jesus by others. Think back. Probably, maybe, your mother and your father. Also, perhaps, teachers and friends. Maybe priests or religious. But somehow or other, we were all brought there, told about this Jesus, the Messiah. And we too had to accept that invitation. accepting that for our baptism, we're also obligated to introduce him to others. We have the word tradition from the Latin traditio, meaning to hand over. We hear many times in the letters of St. Paul, I am handing on to you what was handed on to me. The things he tells us, what he had heard about the resurrection, what he heard about the Eucharist. Paul hands on to others. And for 2,000 years, we've been having this handed down. You and I are the new angels of this world. We have to answer the question, what do we seek? We also have to introduce others in our life, bring them to Jesus. We have to ask, of course, what do we seek? Jesus asks us that question. At times in our lives, we know we seek many things. There's a famous song, looking for love in all the wrong places. I think sometimes in our life, we are looking for many things, but looking for things in the wrong places. Andrew and then Peter knew what they wanted, and they found it in Jesus. Jesus, their Savior. And so we have to ask ourselves, what do we seek? And will we go and see, as Andrew did? And if you do, who will you bring? Who will you hand on the tradition to? Who will you introduce to Jesus? In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Please all stand. In the Lord, let us pray to the Lord. For those physically or emotionally handicapped, that they may be aware that God loves them and that they may serve Him well, let us pray to the Lord. For all of us here, called to be disciples of Jesus, that we may follow Him without fear, let us pray to the Lord.
Father, we try to follow your call. Help us all to love you and to seek your will, now and forever.
Amen. Please be seated, and please join the choir in the offertory hymn 633, 633, verses 1 and 2, verses 1 and 2.
Thank you.
glory of his name, for our good and the good of his church.
Father in heaven, you have called us together, saints and sinners alike, at the table of your Son. With him, we offer you our willingness to carry out in everyday life the tasks you entrust to us. Let your Son give us the courage to be your new people and to be open to the promptings of your love. We ask this in the name of Jesus the Lord.
Amen.
And the Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us lift up our hearts.
We give them unto the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It's right that we give thanks and praise.
Father, all powerful and ever living God, we do well always and everywhere to give you thanks. All things are of your making, all times and seasons obey your laws. But you chose to create us in your own image, setting us over the whole world in all of its wonders. You made us the stewards of creation, praise you day by day as marvels of your wisdom and power. Jesus Christ our Lord. We praise you, Lord, with all the angels in that song of joy. Holy. When the supper ended, then took the cup and again gave him thanks and praise. He gave the cup to his disciples and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all, so that sins may be forgiven. Do this in memory of me." Through him, with
Please hold still.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, and thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the second coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you in peace, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church gathered here. Grant us the peace and unity of that kingdom where you live now and forever. Amen.
Amen.
Lamb
of God, who take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please be. Please receive it. May we ask you to please return the kneelers to their proper places to facilitate the fastings for communion. And please remember that children who have not yet received their first Holy Communion, as well as adults who have not been baptized, may not partake of the host. However, they may come forward and receive a blessing. Tadayma para sa itay hayo ni narimasin. Sen kayo kita katulitusin dyan katawako. Sen kayo itadatimasin. Sende o kete uramianay na taliwa, kasukupuli ti samas mure. Unuzumi mo katawa, maini o susuminari ti awawasi at amos kusi, sagide o tachibulasay. Please join the choir in singing the communion hymn 542, 542 verses 2 and 3, verses 2 and 3.
Thank you.
St. Ignatius Church, the Novena and Procession begin at 2:30 at the entrance to TV Hall. The TV Hall is located beside the store, religious store. Then the English Mass and Blessing of St. Ignatius Status takes place from 3 p.m. after the Mass. A fellowship program follows at 4 p.m. at the Regia Hall. January 18th to 25th is the Octave of Prayer for Christian Unity. Pamphlets with prayers for unity are in the blues. Prayers for unity are said at each Mass. Please leave the pamphlets in the blues. On Saturday, January 21st, Father Vitali will hold a follow-up program for those recently baptized or about to be baptized and their godparents. This takes place in St. Joseph Hall at 2 p.m. Today, after this Mass, there will be a brief meeting of the English Speak International Group. This takes place from 1:30 to 2 in room 301 of the church building. Our regular request, thank you for not eating, drinking, and feeding your children inside the church. You may take home the missalettes with you as the readings for the week are written at the back. Please return the leaders to their proper places and put the hymn books in the pews. And please join us after Mass in praying the Holy Rosary outside in front of our Lady's statue, which is to the right as you have seen. Thank you for your cooperation. Please stand.
Let us pray. Loving Father, you have let us encounter Jesus, your Son, in the word he spoke to us and in the bread which he broke with us. We thank you for trusting us so much, standing our weakness, called us by name to be signs of your goodness and unfailing mercy. Let all we think and say and do be grateful answer of love to you. Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Closing hymn 605, 605 verses 1 and 2.